The Congress party has hit back after questions were raised on Rahul Gandhi's religion by the BJP after his visit to the Somnath Temple in Gujarat. A day after senior Congress leader Kapil Sibal said that Modi has given up Hinduism and adopted Hindutva. Party's UP chief Raj Babbar claimed that Amit Shah is not a Hindu but a Jain. Religious politics are taking center stage in Gujarat. Remember, controversy first broke out after Rahul Gandhi's alleged entry in a register at the Somnath Temple was picked up by the BJP, where they claimed that he had signed on in a register that was meant for non-Hindus. The Congress, however, had put out another photograph saying that Rahul Gandhi had signed in the right register and the wrong entry had actually been made by someone from the BJP after he left the temple. After a raging row over Congress Vice President Rahul Gandhi's signature on the non-Hindu register at Gujarat Somnath Temple, now Rahul Gandhi has issued a clarification that saying that he's a Shiv Bhakt but does not use religion for votes. This even as battleground Gujarat is ridden with only religious rhetoric from netas to archbishops to priests. Is religion the only thing that matters in Gujarat polls? Here's a ground report.
May your family Shiv Bhakt.
Rahul Gandhi claims he's a Shiv Bhakt. The Congress vice president finally breaks his silence on his faith after a raging controversy over his signature in a register meant for non-Hindus at Gujarat's Somnath Temple. In a closed-door meeting with businessmen and traders in Amreli, Rahul Gandhi claimed that he's a Shiv Bhakt and that he does not trade religion for votes.
Meri dadi, meri family, Shiv Bhakt. Hum in cheezon ke bare mein bolte nahi hain. Kyunki hame lagta hai ki jo hamara dharm hai, wo hamari cheez hai. Aur wo hamare andar hai aur hame kisi ko matlab certificate dene ki koi zarurat nahi hai. Ye jo hamari cheez hai, is par hum vyapar nahi karna chahte.
Congress also sharpened its attack and called Prime Minister Narendra Modi a non-Hindu.
Pradhan Mantri ji roz ke roz kitni baar mandiron mein jaate hain. Mandir ka to wo aadar karta hai jo Hinduism ki bhavnaon ka aadar kare. Aap to Hindu dharm ko chhod chuke hain. Aapne to Hindutva ko apnaya hai, jiska Hindu dharm se kuch lena dena nahi hai. Aap to asli Hindu hai hi nahi.
Which religion did Mr. Rajiv Gandhi say he belonged to?
He certainly was a practicing Hindu.
By birth, Mr. Rahul Gandhi, what is he?
He's a Christian. His mother, in the certificate given to Italy, and she said he's Christian. As far as Somnath Temple is concerned,
right,
I have been there many times. Mm-hmm. I have never ever been asked to sign a book.
Na keval Congress upadhyaksh Shri Rahul Gandhi Hindu dharm se hain, parantu wo janeu dharu dhari Hindu.
Muslims versus Hindus versus Christians. Mandir, Masjid, Azan. Netagiri is dharm ki ladai.
Vikas ko.
Sabka vote, kiska vikas?
Religion city hai, Somnath Mandir ka vikas hua, shahar ka nahi hua.
Gujarat Archbishop and the priests face off.
When we read even in the dailies or on the TV, when we come across certain incidents, we begin to question where are we heading to. And so it is a daily affair and it is happening very rampantly in our country, and that is a sad thing.
Does religion rule pole-bound Gujarat? It's Dharm Yudh versus India First. With Preeti Chaudhary, Supriya and Jumana Shah, Bureau Report, India Today.
After the BJP questioned Rahul Gandhi's religion, now the Congress has hit back and claimed that Amit Shah, BJP president, is not a Hindu but a Jain. That statement came from Congress's UP chief Raj Babbar. Take a look. Let's get a word from our correspondent Supriya, who's with us live from the national capital. Supriya, you know, religion now becoming a real issue in this elections. First, the BJP released those photographs of Rahul Gandhi's alleged entry in a register meant for non-Hindus at the Somnath Temple. The Congress now hitting back.
Well, yes, as far as the entire Gujarat campaign is concerned, it started on the issue of development, because people were asking what had happened to the development, how the things have, but the way things are approaching towards the date of polling, we have seen that both the parties and the major players are going all out and talking on the religious line. On one hand, BJP asked Rahul Gandhi that whether he's a Hindu or not, and now it's Congress's chance to hit back, saying that Amit Shah, the president of BJP, has to clarify that whether he's a Jain or a Hindu. Now, this is a debate, the war of words, which is refusing to die down. And as far as the issue of development is concerned, of Vikas is concerned, that has taken a backseat. And it seems who from the political arena is entering into the fray and asking only one question: what is your religion?
All right. Religion clearly becoming an issue in Gujarat. But Supriya, what are the voters saying? Are they happy with the development model that Narendra Modi speaks of and the model that the BJP has been highlighting for so many years?
Well, if you go and talk to the voters in and across the entire Gujarat, they are talking about this basic issue, the issue of GST. They're talking about how demonetization has hit them, how they need more facilities as far as the medical and the education field are concerned. And at the same time, they're also talking about as to how the government is going to take more steps to improve the basic infrastructure in the state and will provide them job opportunities. So this is the issues which the people at ground zero are raising. But as far as the political parties are concerned, the election is heading towards communalism for sure.
Right, Supriya, thanks so much for that. We're going to keep coming back to you for more.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also, check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.